So let me first call all our friends, you know, Dr. M.M. Sharma, Professor M.M. Sharma, who is our chief guest of honor, and I want to say that here is a very big applause. How many people are here? Please give a big hand. Hi, sir. Dr. M.M. Sharma is a Padma Vibhushan, and he is, as I know, his mentor and teacher to none other than the great scientist Mashelkar, and also he has been the mentor and I would say a teacher to Mr. Mukesh Amani. So again, please give him a big hand. At least I'm here. Then we have none other than, I call him father, Suresh Sharma ji, to come. He is the chairman of the Indo-China Economic and Cultural Council. He is also chairman of the Global Cancer Mission. It's a very important area he's working on. So the Global Cancer Mission is run by him, and we must definitely, and Sharmaji, whenever he is there, is a great inspiration for all of us. He is the mentor chair for the Markenomy issues. Please give him a big hand. We have amongst us, as I said, Shashank Shah. May I call Shashank ji? Shashank is an eminent businessman, and the family is now into, I think, third generation of business, sir. Third or fourth generation, sir? Fourth generation, yeah. And they are the oldest dealers of Kirloskar, and also Jyoti, the company I worked for. Of course, Jyoti is not doing well right now. But yes, other than that, Shashank has got the wonderful thing he brought. He has got a link with the agroeconomy of India, because the power tillers in this country became popular because of Shashank Shah and his company, Vijay Power Tillers. Please give him a big hand for that. So agriculture, pump set, power tillers, so it's a very important area, and I think he would know what the farmer needs and how the agroeconomy works, how they're funded, how the loans are taken. All this being at the other side of the dealership, and he has done all this for years together. May I call Dr. P. Sekhar, a very good friend today, and he's somebody whom I have liked all this while. He's got excellent ideas, and please give him a big hand. He's the author of The Blue Economy, a concept which is different, and he would tell more about it, but in brief, as I tell you, instead of getting into landlocked areas and getting into this system, he believes that we can unlock the power of the islands on the Indian Ocean and around almost all the states. So it's a very difficult shift, but I think it's difficult but not impossible. So it's an interesting area which he has touched upon. So we have him amongst us. So please again give him a big hand. And last but not the least right now for me is Kiran Kapilaji, whom I have met, and I tell you, I have become a big admirer of Kapilaji because of the way he handles his business, the way he thinks. He is the chairman and managing director of ICT, the largest consultant for, I would say, infrastructure in India, and they are operating in roughly 45 countries. That's what I understand from him. And he's also our man of the day, because I would say, unless we hear people like him on infrastructure, we will not know what this country is going through. May I ask our friend, the all-star friend, to please come? Sir, please come. Sanjay, Bhide, aaiye. So wonderful to have him here. Aaiye, sir. Nautiyal, sir. He's a senior most man. Please give him a big hand. So wonderful, Nautiyal, sir. Wonderful to have you here. Everybody permits, I will immediately start with requesting the chief guest of honor to say a few words on today. And the question that I have is, sir, you have seen so many things happening in this country. You have seen the country moving forward as well. From our own perspective, it has grown. But I just would like you to throw, what are the important things now that the next India has to catch up? The real India, the superpowering of India, what direction it has to take? What are the four or five key elements that it needs to focus upon?
Let me first of all greet the persons in the dais. I think Professor Iyer made a reference to power generation, renewable energies and all. One of the big lacuna I find is the energy storage. And most of you know that India has zero lithium. We don't have any lithium, and we also don't have any lithium recovery units in India. We need to work on energy storage if we want security from non-renewable sources, and look for non-lithium based batteries and recovery of lithium from the used batteries. We're talking big about electric cars and all, but we are big zero in terms of lithium based batteries, and lithium is controlled by just some countries, 2-3 countries in the world. He was referring to what we should be doing. I mean, we have this slogan, no red tape, only red carpet. Isn't it more a slogan than an actual reality? So if you want to grow, my simple message will be, unless you become proactive in promoting industry, what SECOM did in the very beginning. Maharashtra took leadership through SECOM, which became a model for the rest of the country. Alas, today the situation is dramatically different. So unless we become proactive in attracting industry, rather than industry facing bureaucrats and they said, oh, why you want this, why we put so many impediments. The funny part is, the areas created by the, let's say, Maharashtra MIDC, in those areas which they develop, when you want to expand, there are so many impediments. Is this the way to grow? Answer is emphatic no. So if we really want to grow, one single point formula is that we must become proactive. That we need industry, we need services very badly. Now there is reference to power, that we have, somebody says we have surplus power. I think it is so bemeaning to say that we are surplus power, or some state says we surplus power. That means we have no growth there. I was mentioning to my neighbors while we were sitting in the front. And look at a horrible situation. I am party to initial part in sugar factories to go for cogen. And if you analyze the balance sheet of many sugar companies, you will find they are making more money in selling power than selling sugar. There are some companies which have 60 megawatts, 80 megawatts of surplus power. Now it was so stupid to put boilers generating steam at 10, 12 bar or 15 bar, when everywhere in the world in sugar factories the steam generation was 60 bar plus. So you know, there are some kinds of mistakes that we keep on making. But the entrepreneurship in India is so good that in spite of all the impediments of the government, we continue to grow. And we will grow because of this entrepreneurial skills of our people. I am very impressed with the entrepreneurship that is prevalent almost throughout India. Look, even construction companies like GVR and all, they have come up, where were they? Let me give you the example of pharma industry. 7 companies are more than $1 billion per annum, and none of them belong to business house. They were all technocrat driven companies, whether it was Ran Bakshi or Reddy's or Lupin, all of them were techno driven. They had no background of industry in their family. This is what is making India. That people, or you look at Lakshmi Mittal, or you look at Agarwal, Anil Agarwal, they had no business background. And today, who matters? There was a reference made while Professor Iyer was talking, that the most efficient steel plant probably is JSW. And look at the size of the oxygen plant that they have. Now, Tata's were so big, but to best of my mind, the norms of consumption in Jamshedpur probably won't compare favorably with what JSW is able to. They didn't belong. They were that was not a business. Mr. Jindal was a petty trader in Haryana. So these are technocrat persons who have a fire in the belly, who are able to grow, and they know how to overcome impediments that come. You have to accept when you start. Let me tell you, even in academic world, you are nothing but impediments. I mean, you look at the kind of vice chancellors that are in state universities. Less said the better. I'm willing to say more on the platform, but this is not the forum to talk. But if you clip, one of the things that is taught in engineering is, look for solutions, even though they might be partial. But don't clip about this impediment, that impediment, this impediment. So Professor Iyer, when you said, I think you have to take for granted, we'll have innumerable impediments in India. and that from the beginning you should know how to overcome these impediments in every sphere. Even people who are NGOs who want to do good work, even they encounter problems. Even if you want to do good to others, there are impediments. But accept that impediments are there and go ahead. I am very happy that you are recognizing people from different areas. I think recognition of people who do good is a very fine cultural activity, apart from everything else. And everybody says the last recognition comes from in-house. So if you belong to an organization, you might do extraordinary work. Somehow Professor Iyer made a reference to Larsen Toubro. I was once required to address executives. And they said they have innovation center in Baroda. I was pretty blunt. I said, do you have the DNA to do innovations? Innovation means something risk-taking. Innovation means you should be prepared for failures. Now you want to go for something which are cocksure. That's not how innovations are done. And one of the very popular example I gave, since in India, there's another point I want to stress, that you cannot innovate unless you own failures. Our society has a very serious lacuna. If we look at our own family, we don't own any failure. If the boy or the girl hasn't done well in exam, we'll give many excuses. Pichle din bimar ho gaya tha, ye ho gaya tha, but don't own that person didn't do well. This is the single most impediment in doing innovations in India, because we don't have culture of owning failures. And this PET bottle, which is so prevalent in the world, makes 60 billion bottles a year. Mr. Wyatt, who did this work in DuPont, had 10,000 failures. 10,000 failures. He persisted. And PET bottle today, everybody takes it for... So without failures, you don't have success. So this is the second important point, Professor Bhide, that unless you cultivate this culture of failures, innovations won't come. And when the owners take the onus of developing, would Nano have ever come if Ratan Tata didn't take interest? Would Scorpio ever come if Anand Mahindra didn't take? Would four-stroke TVS would have come if Mr. Srinivasan didn't take direct interest? So it's very important for the business houses owners, unless they own themselves. Why it is that in the earlier days Ran Bakshi could do many things? Because the owner was willing to take all the risks. So this is the key part, that you must own failure, you must give. And I have always believed in this famous saying, apna haath jagarna. If sooner Indians realize that we are very capable people, have faith and give up that colonial culture. As a consultant to industry for more than 50 years, what annoys me most, when we give some idea, one of the questions that is often flung at you, has anybody done it in the world? I said, why are you asking me this stupid question? I'm blunt. I'm giving the idea. You comment on the idea, don't ask me this silly thing, has anybody done in the world or not? This, unfortunately, is the problem in our country, because we have not got out of that slavish attitude that we would be the first in the world. And we are quite capable. And why these Indian genes are getting expressed in Silicon Valley? Because you get the freedom. Here, the ambience comes in the way. Money by itself doesn't guarantee innovation. You need ambience. And it is our job collectively, singly and collectively, to create an ambience for innovation. And I'm sure that you will also create an award for outstanding innovations. Mr. Professor Iyer, I trust that you are giving so many awards that you will also give an award for a high-class innovation.
Sure.
Thank you. I wish you great time.
I think so. May I request our dignitaries here to please light the ceremonial lamp. Please give a big hand to our people on the dais.
Thank you. every time there is a laugh, there was a laugh.
We have amongst us Mr. Tamal of MINT, and since he is here, we will take the opportunity to have a few words from him on the area of only one question. You know, we are journalists, so I will ask you, what do you think about the current infrastructure situation of the country, and where do we go forward from here? Please, sir. Please come over, sir.
Good afternoon. I'm not prepared at all. You know, Mr. Sharmaji, I have tremendous respect for him. So he had asked me, and it's an order. So I thought I'd have to come. I had some work, so I had to rush. And honestly, listen, I just want to say it's. I just here for 10 minutes and all. I didn't even know that what is the situation all about when it was the real all about. But now that I see it's a recognition of MSMEs and SMEs and this kind of efforts. I think it's very laudable thing, sir, and I just have to know that you have been doing it for years. So my congratulations to you. And I don't think this is a time to talk on infrastructure, etc., etc. I mean, everybody knows what's the kind of situation. It's a long way to go. We have been trying various ways, various models, public-private partnership, state initiative, everything. But at the end of the day, India is a situation where all this personal initiative, whatever the best institutions that have come up, and everywhere, it's all the personal initiative that sort of matters. And of course, when it comes to infrastructure, and rightly so, you have Mr. Vajpayee in here, that golden quadrilateral that he started his government. I think that's the best case where what we can do and where we can go. So it's extremely significant that you have Mr. Vajpayee here and you're talking about infrastructure. So that way, I think the larger issue is corporate governance, which again you saw that the biggest 1.8 billion banking scam that we are struggling with this. So while we need initiatives everywhere in the corporate world, infrastructure world, and India is unlike China, which is everything state driven in Indian context, everything. Most of the things happen by initiatives of entrepreneurs and all. Larger issues which is under threat is the corporate governance, as things coming up every day under somewhere or another. No, people stealing money and running away from the country. So that's not a very good domain. But Sharmaji, thank you for calling me. As I said, your calling is an order. I came. Unfortunately, I had to rush. And next time, definitely, I will come and spend longer time. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Tamalji, for being here. And before that, I wanted to give a few things on Atalji, because the key issue is the golden quadrilateral. Then here's the idea of the diamond quadrilateral, unfinished agenda. Aaj bhi humare 4 saal mein sarkar ne nahi uthaya. Sorry, main ekdam neutral position pe baitha hu aur main zarur is baat ko kahunga ki hum fail ho gaye 4 saal mein unki diamond quadrilateral ki baat nahi kari gayi. Uska kaam nahi kiya gaya. Aur ek hai, I hope मैं प्रधानमंत्री जी को कुछ हफ्तों में रिमाइंड कर सकूंगा इज अ ब्यूटीफुल प्रोजेक्ट ऑफ कल्पास यू नो द कल्पास वाज गुजरात्स बेस्ट प्रोजेक्ट दैट कुड हैव इट वाज अ प्रोजेक्ट व्हिच कुड एक्चुअली बी बोथ इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर एज वेल एज वाटर रिसोर्स प्रोजेक्ट फॉर द एंटायर वेरावल एंड कच्छ रीजन सो दैट इज मिसिंग बिकॉज़ दैट वाज कंसीडर्ड टू बी अ फ्रैक्शन यू गाइस कैन गो ऑन गूगल एंड फाइंड आउट अबाउट कल्पास बट आई डोंट वांट टू डिटेल इट हियर बट बेसिकली द रॉटरडम पोर्ट इज इन्वॉल्वड इन द प्रोजेक्ट The guidance given, it's a world-class project. I tell you, it is a project to convert seawater into usable, potable water as well as water for navigation. It's the most interesting, it's a multi-purpose project. You know, compared to a hydro project, this is a very excellent, different kind of tidal come hydro project. You can also have tidal energy in that. So I hope this is touched by the Prime Minister. So two things which has not been done. And definitely the third part which Atalji always wanted is he was also the first You know, I'd say, okay, Rajiv Gandhi started with Sam Petroda, the IT team. But I was always a critic on that. Although it started, I'm happy that Rajiv Ji started it. But what happened later on is Atalji. He started and moved the IT revolution, and the late Pramod Mahajan was responsible for bringing the first changes. But yes, every leader did his bit. What we are talking about, Digital India and all this platform, would have not come if Atalji's time did not put its base in the IT industry, moved a little forward, you know, in that direction. And then we thought about a digital concept, you know, over a period of time. We are not calling different names, but actually it starts from the 2004. Because the unfinished agenda was he lost elections, as simple as that. You know, if he had been given 5 more years, I believe he would have done much big wonders to the country. He was a strong leader in his own sense, soft and strong. With these things, I want to give a few figures for people to ponder over, you know. I have brought here the populations of and GDPs of a few, 5 interesting countries, you know. China, 1.35 billion, India, 1.3, United States, 0.33 billion, Indonesia, 0.26 billion, Brazil, 0.21. That's all, you know, the top. And if you look at GDP, you know, China is about, let's say, 12 trillion, you know, US is roughly about 19 trillion, India, you can say 2.5 trillion easily, it's going towards 3 trillion, you know. Then we have, you know, Indonesia and Brazil, their GDPs are much lower, so I'm not naming, but let me name a few countries, you know. Entire European Union put together will be 17 trillion, you know, interesting. But the topmost among them, that is Germany, is around 3.5 trillion. So we see that gap, you know, it's an interesting gap. So India as a country is coming, GDP wise is coming there. But I'm sorry, you know, when I have given all these figures, looks nice, fine, but I'm not happy. I don't think GDP can be the sole measure of economies. The problem is how much of the disparity between the rich and the poor you are able to bring closer, right? Countries are able to achieve this. That is that the very rich, and I would say the very poor and the middle class, there is a kind of an evening out of this process. मतलब उनके अंदर एक तरह से समानांतर था दिखती है खरीदारी में उनके परचेसिंग पावर में और उनके लिविंग स्टैंडर्ड्स में कुछ तरह का समानांतर रूप आया. मैं बहुत सुपर और न्यू रिच की बात नहीं कर रहा हूँ लेकिन एक समानांतरता की बात कर रहा हूँ. तो इन दैट सेंस हम लोगों ने उतना काम नहीं किया है जितना हमें करना चाहिए या उस तरफ हमने काम नहीं किया है. तो आई माई विजिट सिंस 2008 हैज बीन अ स्मॉल कंट्री व्हिच आई एम फॉन्ड ऑफ एंड दैट इज भूटान. आई हैव टू मेंशन दैट ऑलवेज व्हेन आई से and they are wonderful guys. They started the concept of gross national happiness. You know, I'm also working on a project called the GNHH for India, gross national harmony and happiness. My problem is in India the communities are many. In Bhutan there are only 7 lakh population. My own suburb of Dombivli will have 11 to 12 lakhs, you know. Gurgaon could beat them hands down, you know. So it's a small country, but area, how many borders? West Bengal, Assam, Nagaland, Meghalaya, Sikkim, you know. And they also say there's a border around where they can also reach Tripura and all. I'm not talking about at least 5 borders with India, you know. Such a country, and 70% of the landmass is forest, secure and safe, and the rest which is utilized, and water resource is the key, and the only carbon negative country in the world, producing only power from hydro and renewable energy and driving the entire population. So I hope they are able to sustain in that manner. But whatever they have done, and their prime minister met, and he became, I wrote to Modi ji that time, he, the first country he should visit was Bhutan. Luckily he visited that country only. And it's good, you know, because that's the prime minister, so they will have an election, they will have a change. They also embrace democracy in a very interesting sense. Why I keep that name? Because happiness is most important. Are we able to measure? So as an engineer by background, I would say we in India need a set of researchers who create a mathematical model to achieve this. Because we are not able to quantify and qualify. And that is the sole reason that we are only thinking of GDP and not thinking of the idea of happiness. And happiness is fundamental to Indian society. The family is the core, right? Then you have the, when you go to the office, I tell you, your colleagues spend more time, all of us know, than even with your family. So this is another extended family many times. So people like Shashank have operated that way. And I also have operated that way as much as I can see it that way, you know. So you always have, and Kapila Sahib has a bigger family than us, you know. He is operating with this organization as an extended family. So I hope that this Indian ethos sets in, and it's important that only currency does not become the metaphor for our educational institutions as well. And actually today, last week I was put up as an associate dean for the New Delhi Institute of Management. I'm also professor for public policy now for them. But as I would always advise that why not create new students who are not only the mula, but they are out to make a change and also get compensated, you know. So I think we have to put something new into our management education, our technology education. Unless we don't give them life skills. हाथ से काम करना नहीं जानते हैं, एसी रूम में बैठना चाहते हैं, डैम कौन बनाएगा, सड़कें कौन बनाएगा, और बाकी से कौन करेगा, ये बहुत बड़ा सवाल उठेगा, क्योंकि ये नहीं कर पाएंगे तो आई डोंट थिंक वी विल बी एबल टू अचीव फार ग्रेटर सक्सेस देन व्हाट वी हैव ओनली डन. सो वी रिमेन इन स्पाइट ऑफ कंट्री दैट डिफाइंड इट एंड नॉट बिकॉज ऑफ इकोनॉमी, बिकॉज किसी तरह से कोई तो शक्ति है, है वो जो हमें चला रही है. सो विद दीस वर्ड्स आई वुड रिक्वेस्ट अ फ्यू वर्ड्स फ्रॉम ईच ऑफ माय पीपल ऑन द डायस. फर्स्ट starting with Dr. Sekhar, please sir. Please give up your time.
After a power-packed talk by Prof. Iyer, the way he talks, we don't need any energy. His talk has got so much energy, the mic itself is blasting. So, anyway, he has said few minutes. I would stick to that few minutes, otherwise, you know, his power will
So, while introducing me, he did introduce something about blue economy. I do work a lot on blue economy, smart city concepts, and more than any of this, something which I call a self-sustained economy. Sustained economy is something which we do. Self-sustained is something by which the money can come from the system. Whatever we do, NHA may like to have 5 lakh crores of roads to be built. Where will the money come from? Our whole economy is such that we collect about 14 lakh taxes. 80% goes in salaries and all. Remaining 20 to 25% cannot pay this 5 lakh crores. We all may dream that money should be spent by government. Government should do this, government should do that. The intentions are there with all this corruption and everything. But it cannot come from the sky. So, I have worked deeply on some of these figures, and many of these figures are now in public domain, and many India and many countries are following, which I call it as a secured governance. In this concept, I am saying how a self-sustained economy will come, where the money will come, and how these infrastructure and other things can be seen into a reality. What we are trying to suggest to people is, infrastructure gives huge valuation. Capture this valuation and create infrastructure free. What does it mean? It means that a simplest example is a road. The moment even NHA says I may like to do this road even after 5 years, already values around the roads have started going up. But does NHA capture any portion of the road today? No. True to all, how can you do? So, we have worked out a concept by which they can capture this value. Simplest way is, instead of talking only of the road, talk of two hubs around the road. Hubs means what? A smart city. I tend to tend in such a way that which Kapila and other group people will always be ready to work forward, is the hub maker can make the road free because he gains the whole value of the road. So, imagine properly, a road, before the road comes, values around the road, you may get a house even for 800 rupees a square foot. The moment the road even is announced, the 800 becomes 1200. The moment the road is made, it goes to 3000. The moment it saturates, it goes to another 1 or 2 years, it becomes almost 6000, 8000. And if I have something like 1 million square foot, imagine the value multiplication. And we have calculated that hardly 5% of this value which is created is the cost of the road. So the road itself comes almost free. It is a question of configuring it properly. Now many projects of this nature are going forward. Remove the road free. Remove the road. Have a hospital. Hospital brings value. Then the value can be captured. Have a school. School brings value. Value can be captured. Have a good sanitation. That gives value. So every one of these which can bring value can bring the main infrastructure itself. In that connection only, we had postulated the smart cities, India in need of 200 smart cities. But the way the government is doing is not the way we had postulated long back. We had wanted all these smart cities as a green field, which means at the remote area, and give best of the infrastructure there. Because if you see, we talked about Bombay, Delhi and all. Delhi and Bombay are the best places to live with 8 to 10 million people. With 20 million plus, which both the cities are there, it is a collapse city. You bring any amount of infrastructure above this, what will happen? This 20 can become 40. Because India has got so much population to come, which is throbbing to come in. Instead of that, our philosophy, which coincidentally many of the municipal corporations are now adopting, bring satellite cities around the place so that the main city, in fact, will get less population than what it is today. There's need to decongest the city rather than get the city more and more populated. So once you have decongested satellite cities coming in, automatically there will be growth and proper growth. City also will be good and other place also will be good. The moment I keep on putting more and more roads, there's no money for the roads. At the same time, the population will grow. Now, a little of blue economy. I'm just trying to rush through. Maybe till the light is on, I have to talk. This blue economy is a water-based economy. Since while introducing me, he was talking about islands and all. We have done extensive work on blue economy. Now, in water-based economy, there are two aspects. One is inland water, one is the ocean. And in ocean, India has got 1,300 islands. And can you believe about 11 of them are even bigger than Singapore? Very big islands. 800 of them are totally unoccupied. 800 of them. And even this 1,300 islands put together has got only 2 million population. There's so much of, you know, space, prosperity, and need to go there. And today, believe it or not, India is spending almost 50,000 crores to maintain them as our territory. So what we have suggested, in fact my own book on blue economy says, blue economy is a $1 trillion economy. Because all these things are assets of the country. And we need to only do the same PPP model. Okay. Only in my case, the last P, I remove partnership by participation. What Dr. Kapila was saying, that almost so much of money of the banks are blocked. Because in partnership, you become wedded. In participation, you do and go. So that the money spills, the project gets completed. That means, in this PPP model, if you can put on all these islands will come almost maybe get rid of the debt in our country's balance sheet. India has got almost, believe it or not, almost 50 lakh crores as debt in the balance sheet. And each and every state, Maharashtra is the highest with almost 4.5 lakh crores. So these things can go if these islands can be brought in, because it is just like I am in debt and some long lost person is saying, oh, your grandfather left some XYZ property, then my debt goes. Same. There's something which is with us as our asset. And this asset, if it is used properly, and these assets, almost there could be 11 Singapores in India. Singapore is considered to be one of the best countries in the world. We can have that almost in the same direction. We have got those islands. And even other islands can be tourism hub, you name it, they can make a huge dent in India's prosperity. Same thing with respect to smart city. Till the village level, smart city should go. It should not be left to the basic municipal corporations only. So with that, maybe 10 minutes before our host tells me the time is up, I will just close my talk. Thank you so much.
I understand, you know, that I would now request Shashank Shah, our businessman for excellence, would have loved him to be on the part of the award, but today on the dais.
Nice. Good evening. And all the dignitaries on the dais, ladies and gentlemen. I'm by mistake over on this side. I should have been on that side, to be honest. Okay, and that is because of Professor Iyer's love that I'm here today. Fundamentally, Mr. Iyer is really carrying out a great work, you know. And I look at his talking about the state's growth, he's talking about Swachhata, honoring the best municipal corporations in the country, talking about ports. So he's covered all the gamuts of what is the growth really is happening in all the sectors. And I hope that he gets on with this continuously, and the discussion on the various such disciplines in the growth for the country is quite essential. and I wish him all the best in his endeavor. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
I am thankful to all, and I want Nautiyal sir, our eldermost gentleman, to say a few words before Sharma ji winds up with his, you know, I would say his brilliance as usual.
Abhi main aapse ek baat kehta hoon, kyunki maine sabko suna nahi, to isliye main jo apne man mein hai woh bol deta hoon. हमारे देश में मेरे ख्याल से एक ही समस्या है. वो समस्या यह है कि हमारे करोड़ों हाथ हैं लेकिन उन हाथों को काम नहीं है. एक समस्या, एक ही आदमी पैदा हुआ था इस देश में, मैं आपसे फिर कहता हूं, जिसका नाम अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी है. मैं 88 के करीब तो पहुंच गया हूं, और जब स्कूल में डाला था तो एक तो साल की डंडी मारी हुई होगी कि एक साल ये बेटा जो है बीमार पड़ जाएगा, एक साल जो है फेल हो जाएगा. तो भाई सरकारी नौकरी में जाने के लिए एक आध साल की गुंजाइश रखो तो उम्र घटा दे. तो मैंने कहा कि एक ही आदमी पैदा हुआ विश्वेश्वरैया के बाद, अटल बिहारी वाजपेयी, जिसने कहा कि इस देश के खाली हाथों को काम पर लगाओ, जिसने कहा कि नदियों को जोड़ो, जिसने कहा कि सेना चाहिए इस देश को, देश की सुरक्षा के लिए, कि लेकिन जमीन पर काम करने के लिए लैंड आर्मी बनाओ. और उन्होंने लैंड आर्मी की बात की थी. तो वो जो लैंड आर्मी, आप इतने लोगों ने आज पुरस्कार प्राप्त किए, अवार्ड प्राप्त किए, अरे आप तो एक से बढ़कर के आदमी हो. इतनी क्षमता इस देश की मैं देख रहा हूं आपके अंदर, और इतनी सारी क्षमताओं को अगर हम इस देश के हर हाथ को काम देने के लिए पर लगा दें, तो ये देश चीन वीन क्या है कुछ भी नहीं, कुछ नहीं है. मैं आपसे कहता हूं कुछ नहीं है. अब दिक्कत क्या है कि हम जो तरक्की करते हैं, तरक्की जिसका नाम है, वो यूं ऊपर की तरफ जाती है, चांद पर हम जाएंगे और कहां कहां हम पहुंच जाएंगे, और क्या, और जमीन की तरफ देखो, नीचे की तरफ देखो, तो हमारी तरक्की नीचे पहुंच ही नहीं पाती और गड्ढे में जा रहे हैं नीचे. तो भाई आप सब विद्वान लोग हो, प्रोफेसर शर्मा जी, आप सब लोग, मेरा आपसे निवेदन एक ही है कि आप सब लोग मिल करके फिर कोशिश करो कि शायद ये जो तरक्की जो ऊपर जा रही है वो नीचे की तरफ भी लौट पा रही है. धन्यवाद.
सो टुडे द फिनाले, सुरेश शर्मा जी.
सबको नमस्कार. I shall meet the President as to the last word. Prime Minister Iyer has spoken and he had none to question him. But I'm not misused my power to do that. I'm here to say my few words. First, of gratitude. एहसान मंद हूं मैं उन सबका जिन्होंने आज की शाम यहां कर हमारे ख्यालों को इजाफा दिया है. अपनी अपनी कलाओं के जरिए, अपने हुनरों के जरिए जो हमारे ख्याल थे उनको तारवीर दी है, उन्हें शक्ल दी है, उन्हें मुकाम दिया है. I am grateful to each one of them who have achieved in their respective places. To Kapila, to Sekhar, to Shashank. Bhide?
Sanjay.
Ram Bhide? Sanjay Bhide. I learned humility from a man called Nandkishore Nautiyal. आपने बताया कि शख्स ने नाम सुना ब्लिट्स अखबार का 50 साल पहले ब्लिट्स अखबार हुआ करता था उसका मालिक था प्रोफेसर गोपाल कृष्ण अय्यर उसका नाम था करंजिया रूप उनका ही था When he spoke the word, the whole world is like to me. Not one could dare not listen to him. Was that? He found his going was too tough. कहाँ जो अगले जानते नहीं थे उनके लिए मुश्किल पड़ती थी. He went around the country to find somebody who could be the voice of his reasoning, which was not reasonable. After having done the lot of such that he had done, Kabilaji, he did zero in on Nautiyal. 25 long years, Nautiyal ke darwaze par sekdon hazaron ministers ne, secretaries ne, politicians ne, par ne kya kya nahi kiya. But Karanjiya not for the trade off. Karanjiya was not for the trade off. No one was there for Nautiyal. Yahan tak ki Nautiyal ne inkar kiya. Sarkar Marsh Sarkar ko inkar kiya. Main aapke kote se as a journalist jo mera due hai, main flat nahi lunga. Sahi hai? Number two, इन्होंने इनको कहा गया कि आप अपने पब्लिकेशन है उसके लिए हम आपको जमीन देना चाहते हैं मैं आपको 2 acres देना चाहता हूं He said no because he was not able he was not prepared for not talked about to trade off the trade of not trading off comes to very few people in the world and those who have been In that very frame of God's kingdom, God's kindness, is a man called Professor M.M. Sharma. I, on the 9th of June last year, I saw as a witness a man called Mashelkar, his student. He was speaking. He choked. He could not speak few words midway down for 3 minutes. He did wipe his tears off Kabilaji. But people could really imagine ke Sharmaji ke 18 saal retirement ke baad he converted a small college called UDCT into the dim university which is the world's only topmost one note today. Professor Sharma. I saw that evening about 83 people. Each one wanted to have a word on his birthday to see how grateful they were. He touched them. He looked at them. He talked them. He sat with them. He made them cry, made them laugh, made them drool. Such men called Professor Sharma, like Mr. Nautiyal. I've seen Nautiyal just a few days ago. Again the same story. Came no line down the highway. Incidentally, Mr. Nautiyal is, I think, the 11th Nobel, currently. He's 88 young now. But he does not say, I will never die. He said, I retired. T-Y-R-E. I don't get tired. So he said, I will not pick up the small airport. I'll come here. He came here. He showed the spirit. But I say, I'm very grateful. I'm not humility. But the biggest instrument that he has got in his hand, not only, is his humor. In a few words that he has spoken this evening, he put it succinctly down. Kerala ko aage karna hai, to ye kijiye. Udiye mat. Udiye. Udiye mat. Samjha. Udiye. To udiye mat. Samjhe ka paav rakhiyega. जो रखता है जमीन पर पांव कुछ को ढक नहीं जा सकता आई होप इफ इट हैपेंस वही तारीर एक शख्स में आई है कबीला जी नाम अय्यर है आई थिंक आई वेरी ग्रेटफुल टू दोज हैव टॉट मी ए फ्यू थिंग्स ऑन द अदर टुडे इन एर्लियर बट आई वाज वेरी प्राउड टुडे Very proud of all people who have come in my life, who have appealed to me, impressed me, won me over, again at my young age that I am, to be able to force upon me his very. The man who has done it to me is Professor Iyer. I had to adopt him, he had to adapt me. Together we are doing what we are doing together. But how he has it more important to me? His prognosis, his visioning, assessment visioning. Brother Amir Sharma, when we do the award selection, the whole year round, the research team keeps on working hard. Now tell me what objective that we have to award to state A or B or C? When we're extra blind. Number two, even hundreds of audio agreements are. In our, we have got the data bank of ours. More than 550 top post officials of this country are in our Those who are the ones who have run the institutions of greatest importance in this country, as the chairman or the MD or whatever, they are the ones who are still open to us, to any decision we might, any request we make. They are what he has stated. Now why am I very proud of Professor Iyer? In 2013 or 2014, he envisioned the possibility of Mr. Modi could be sharing, shouldering the world on his shoulders. In 2014,
August 13th.
A year before that happened.
Exactly 1 month
ago. So this is what has happened. We could do that.
1 month before he was appointed a candidate for the Prime Minister.
So we could do that. Now, there's a book called India Brentish he authored. This is a book which is calling about us, talking about us, what's going to happen in 2022. Now please pick up any newspaper. Most teams of the country are being talked about terminating the year 2022. Two things are being talked about today are Make in India. Kabila. Make in India. Shashank. Make in India. And second, women empowerment. Am I right?
Yes.
True? A book published many years ago. Chapter 5. And the title is Genesis of the Indian Brand. The Genesis of the India Brand, the Made in India Phenomenon Born to Excel. President Sharma, like many years ago, he could see what could be happening in this country to become a reformed country, a transformed country. the end of the PhD, next he mentioned how the empowerment came to the country. It came to the culture phenomena, but created by none other than a girl called Sushmita Sen. She caught the eye of the world in the Miss World Cup pageant about it, maybe cool. And because she looked, she rode the way that she did, she led the way for many others to follow. And they had followed Priyanka Chopra, Dara Dutta, and Liana Hayden, etc., etc. Point I'm making here is, we are authors of the books which talk of the day after tomorrow. Yes, ahead. We are not Nostradamus. We are no less. We ambitious to what can happen really. And they were prepared our ground to say to what we could say. And we say what others don't want to say, they can't say. Because they have got extra blind. We don't have. Friends, when we were offering the book, Atal Shastra, We had a discussion. What in case we would mention Mr. Arjun Bira Gashwadi, the best permission of this country? Modi ji kya sochein? Ye gate sa pehle ki baat hai. Tab manthan kiya gaya. Vichar vinimay kiya gaya. Objectively speaking, har ek kul ko parkha gaya. Aur tab ja ke faisla kiya gaya ki based on the stand that we have today available, there is really none other than who can do what others cannot do or did not do. Therefore, we chose Atal Bihari Vajpayee, the best Prime Minister, and to pay tribute to him, we chose to publish this great book called Atal Shastra. The word Shastra came, his philosophy, did what wonders within the hearts of the people, and laid the function, therefore, of trying to make the mind hearty. That's why, even today, when you now find coalition dharma is not easy to follow, easy to foster, you all are saying, let's hold it for Atal Bihari Vajpayee's doctrine. So they call it Shastra. So if you have got today the Shastra, you have got to work out. Got to work out on the strength of Ekala Saruvai, Sabka Saath, Sabka Vikas. Wohi nahi ho raha. Ye kehne ke liye kahi nahi ho raha, ye ho nahi raha. Koi to chali. Who shall bear the cat? That's why Falcon Media Group is talking about few things. Defense, talking infrastructure, talking energy power, small scale sector, and women empowerment. We do issue the awards on these fronts every year, 6-7 times. But we are not a commercial organization. We are not a commercial organization. We are the not-for-profit organization. Hamara kharcha jana chahiye. Udhar na mangna pade. Itni koshi karte hai. To prove it, we have not ever charged any entry fees for any of our occasion, but how big it may have been. Because we have done what we have done in for last 5-6 years in Delhi. अब दिल्ली में हर एक के घर घर हर एक के जो नेता लोग हैं उनके कान में जब फार्कन का या मार्केनोमी का इमीना का नाम पड़ता है चौकन्ने हो जाते हैं इधर आ जाओ पिकर विथ थॉट ऑफ ट्रेन बैक टू आवर ओन होम कॉल बॉम्बे सो दिस आर मोस्ट वीकली टुडे एंड आवर नेक्स्ट फंक्शन 3-4-5 फंक्शन इन होल ईयर इन बॉम्बे. And I can assure you, when you hold the next election, we have not one seat. Aapko kuch kehna padega, kisi ko puchna padega, ye ek seat dala dijiyega. Filhal to humne kaha ye, ki ab aapke har aane ka, har jo shakhs aaya hai, usko dhanyavaad karte hain. Aur mehmani ka shukriya ada karna chahte hain. Aur ye vishwas dena chahte hain. Jo kuch koi aur nahi kehta, hum kehwayenge. Uski wajah kya hai? हम ये कहते हैं कि इनकी बात करता हूँ तो फैसले एक बात कर दिस इज नो एक्स्ट्रा ग्राइंड इज नो ट्रेड ऑफ ये नो एवर सोल्ड इन ए even a single hair on a barter deal. He never cared. If I persist, I'm out. If I'm out, men like Nautiyal are out. Men like Prof. Sharma are out. Why did they come because of me? Many more people come because of Iyer. Because women are special. ईमानदार है, नेक है, शरीफ है, सच्ची है. हम सच्ची को सच मानते ही कहते हैं. वी डोंट, वी आर नॉट मीडिया, वी आर नॉट न्यूज़पेपर. वी डोंट मेक न्यूज, प्रोफेसर शर्मा. वी डोंट कवर न्यूज, मिस्टर नौटियाल. वी फॉर्म ओपिनियंस. वी मेक ब्रांड्स. दैट्स व्हाई वी सेड, इफ यू हैव टू मेक अ ब्रांड, मेक इंडिया द ब्रांड. So in the apprentice phase, we are trying to make India the brand. And when India the brand is sold, their whole country is plugged. Our decision is, in 2022, Markenomy is going to be the mouthpiece of this nation, not only in this country, but the whole world. So there is not one in this city or in this country or in India, which is objective onlooker. And the power he's got, the power of communication, of total truth, but nothing to truth. So those who have had the privilege of being awarded today, they have won it because they won it by sheer dint of their invested capital. The capital is thought, emotion, sentiment, energy, and desire. With those kind of power that we have, I think there is no limit that we can't reach. There is no home which can't lit. There is no road which can't travel. Capitalizing what we don't do, you can. Because we should do it. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Sharma sir. And wonderful speech. I think Professor Sharma requested me. He has some concerns and he wants to highlight that.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have two major concerns. I'm saying my main concern is about water stress. We are having very poor policies on water utilization. Water is going to be a critical factor. You heard today about announcement of Kaveri water and all.
Yes.
But we are supporting crops which are water guzzlers. And being in Maharashtra, I am here to tell you that most hopeless crop is sugarcane.
Yes.
12-month irrigation, everything from A to Z is subsidized. Should we openly question this? Rice. For every kilo of rice you export, please work out how many liters of water we are exporting and we don't have that water. We have plenty of rain in Bombay, in Alibaug. In summer you have to go hunt for water in Alibaug. 110 inches of rainfall. Now, 2/3 of our edible oil is being imported. More than 1 million ton a month. Isn't it a national shame? Once upon a time, we used to be exporter of edible oils. Today, our common item of usage, we are importing and we are critically dependent upon items coming from Malaysia and Indonesia and something from soya from Brazil and Argentina. I think it's a very serious matter for all of us citizens to look into this part of. The other one is, land will keep on shrinking for agriculture. Our productivity is very low. We need to produce much more food. Saying we have some self-sufficiency are bogus statements. A lot of people don't get enough food. We say we have milk revolution, white revolution. Is milk is unaffordable. Imagine a lower middle class person wanting to buy 1 liter of milk per day. Can that person afford 1200 to 1500 rupees a month just for 1 liter of milk a day? And we are saying we are largest producer, there is a white revolution, but look at the cost of living versus the cost of milk, and it is a shocker. I am very much concerned about these issues. And agriculture, now this takes me to an area of being a lifetime academic. There is, as of now, a gross neglect for support for fundamental sciences. Unless you strengthen fundamental sciences, there is no chance of invention, therefore there is no chance of innovation. Would you believe that there are letters written by Government of India to our renowned scientific institutions asking them to justify their existence? They won't ask bureaucrats whether that 150 members in PMO office is justifiable. But they are asking, why should you exist? Now, what would have happened to this country if the scientific institutions were not there? And the growth that has come. Remember, Green Revolution came because there were outstanding agriculture scientists. Today we have problems. You know, the kind of expertise we need to get much more output from our limited land. You look at outside Pune, most of the farms are gone. This is story throughout. So imagine that 5 years' time, 10% less land will be available and 25 to 30% more food will be required. How will you do without a major breakthrough? I'm not talking about genetic modifications on which a lot of controversies come. Although it's a bit of an odd thing that all the vaccines you take are all genetically modified. That you take in your body, you don't object. But you object to other genetic. Now, remember, genetically modified cotton came against all government rules. Gujarat farmers took a decision, we are going ahead, to hell with your rules. They couldn't do anything to the farmers. Now, whether you should take that or not, I'm not bothered. But please bear in mind, the major revolution in edible oil came in the world because rape with normal practices of plant breeding, they brought it to canola. In chemistry language, C22 carbon atom, which is not so good for edible purposes, was brought down to C8 like groundnut oil or till oil. And today, the world is surplus in edible oil on one account because of palm, another account because of canola. Now, for a country like us, such a sensitive item like edible oil, if 65% of our requirement is met by import, we need to make big noises. And we had oil seed thing, by the way, that particular thing was headed by San Petroda. Right. Oil seed mission, and what is the result? I think we need working, not slogans. You need reality. Nautiyal sahab said, upar to jawab agar niche bhi dekho, main niche ki baat kar raha hu. Ke kya karna chahiye zameen ke liye. That is why I wanted to share my concern, because I heard so many things of public interest. I didn't know what kind of audience will be there. So I took it out of turn to request him to let me say something, which I normally wouldn't have done.
Wonderful, sir. It was wonderful. May I share the books which we have for all of our dignitaries of the dais, please? Sharma ji, Suresh Sharma ji will give the books to everybody.